Hi, this is Neil Slade, and I'm going to show you how I replace the pads in my Selmer Alto saxophone. A bit of history here. To the best of my knowledge, I was the first musician on the planet to have an instrument fully fitted with synthetic neoprene pads on the keys. If you're not familiar, woodwind instruments are traditionally fitted with leather pads on the underside of the keycups to seal the air, allowing the notes to change. Way back in 1975, I just obtained a new saxophone from my sax professor at the University of Denver, Ray Corrales. Ray was famous for being featured in nationally posted billboards playing his clarinet, advertising cool cigarettes. At the time, Ray had just accepted a job as a spokesperson from LeBlanc Musical Instruments and had to switch from playing a Selmer brand saxophone to LeBlanc. I was in bad need of a new professional level instrument, and Ray offered to sell me a Selmer. I probably paid Ray $700 or so for the instrument nearly 50 years ago, now valued at least 10 times that. Mine is a super balanced action model made in 1952, the model used by Paul Desmond of Take 5 fame. Anyway, back in 75 or so, shortly after I bought it, the horn needed repadding, and as a devoted vegetarian, I was looking for an alternative. At that time, there was no alternative to leather pads, but I was turned on to a saxophone repair genius who lived 40 miles away in Boulder, Colorado, a man by the name of Dick Johnston. He was truly a world-class technician to whom people from all over the world sent their instruments for repair and tuning. I went to meet him and explained my dilemma, and he offered a possible solution. The material he used was the same as what skin diver suit material was made from. He'd only used neoprene on a few select keys, but suggested that we might try and repad my entire saxophone with neoprene pads, although he, nor anyone else on the planet, had ever tried it before. I gave him the go-ahead, and the result was a resounding success. Not only did the neoprene pads work, but they worked better than the leather pads. Ultimately, Dick repadded all of my instruments in neoprene, my alto and soprano saxophones, a clarinet, and two flutes. Now, typically, leather pads wear out much sooner, often 5 years, maybe 10 years if you are very lucky. These neoprene pads lasted nearly 50 years, and many of them still didn't need replacing at all, although I chose now to repad all the keys just for consistency. My instruments were the first to offer this technological breakthrough, and I eventually built a website explaining how to do it. See the link in the description. At last, in 2020, I discovered a company that had begun to commercially produce and offer synthetic pads like the neoprene pads I had made and which Dick had made back in 1975. I used them this month to repad and replace the last worn-out pads on my saxophone. A link is provided below in the description to Tru-Seal Instrument Pad Company, who provided me with a set of synthetic rubber pads for my alto. These pads come with metal resonators in the center or without, and can be purchased for flute and clarinet as well. The advantages of the synthetic pad is that they last longer than leather pads, are waterproof and heat resistant, and work exceedingly well in sealing up the tone holes. This video shows me repadding one of the side keys, although the procedure was the same for all of the keys. It should be noted that replacing the pads is only part of the job. The most difficult part of the pad overhaul is adjusting the keys in the case that there are minute air leaks if the pad doesn't completely sit properly on the keyhole. But that job of adjusting the leaks or leveling the keys is dealt with on various YouTube videos already online. One last note, all of the background music that you hear, the saxophone music, is me playing this saxophone with the neoprene pad keys. Here's the key that I'm going to replace, is the side key, B flat. You're going to need some equipment to do this job. One is a leak light, and I made a leak light out of a small fluorescent light fixture myself. Just took out the tube and the switch, and you can see me stuffing it into the saxophone. And the leak light is used to see where the keys are leaking or not. When you use the leak light, you've got to use it from all angles and look at the key from above, the side, and below to make sure that it's completely sealing the keycup. You also have to measure the size of the keycup and use a $10 digital caliper to do that. The part that you use is at the top of the caliper, which can be used to measure the inside of the keycup, and you'll see me doing that a little bit later. And you can measure it in inches or millimeters, and it's pretty self-explanatory. You'll need a good set of screwdrivers, teeny tiny Swiss watch screwdrivers are used by some, but I prefer to use these ones from Ace Hardware that come with a very good handle on them. You're going to need some oil, bore oil or 3-in-1. A light oil is good, or even WD-40. And you'll use that to lubricate the post holes and the rods when you replace the keys back on the saxophone. Also, a bit of sandpaper. I use 600 wet or dry sandpaper to clean off the tone hole cover. Also, you can buy a very skinny leak light, which is a USB powered light that works very good on very small sections of a saxophone or a soprano saxophone neck or on a flute. Here I am removing the side key mechanism, the rod first, and then detaching the key, sticking it on the side. You can see the original Selmer resonator on the handmade neoprene key pad here, which I'm removing with the screwdriver. And I would like to keep the original resonators that are, gosh, about 60 years old at this point. I grab the resonator edges with a pair of pliers and then unscrew the screw that holds them back in place onto the handmade pads that we made way back when. Like I said, these pads were 50 years old and they were still working perfectly well, but I just decided to replace all the pads at once on the horn. Here I'm keeping the resonator in a little plastic bag, and I've got a collection of these old Selmer resonators. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with them, but I've got them. Here I'm using the caliper to measure the inside diameter of the keycup, which in this case is about 23 or 23 and a half millimeters, I guess 23.1. So I'll use a 23 millimeter size pad. They make pads as small as 8 millimeters in diameter and up to pads that are 49 or larger, I believe. I'm testing the pad inside the keycup, and it's got a nice white band around it, so you can see that the pad is inserted completely evenly. But before you put it inside the keycup, you've got to remove all the old shellac, which was used to originally level or to hold the original pad in place. Now, I've scraped the inside of the pad keycup to remove all traces of any glue or anything, and I used spray adhesive to keep the pads in place. All I did was spray a little adhesive on some cardboard, and then dip the underside of the pad into the adhesive. Or you can put a little bit of adhesive in the inside of the keycup. I just directly sprayed it in and then fit the pad in there and press to the center. If you do use the spray adhesive, if you do get a little bit on the pad by accident, you can remove it with a Q-tip and WD-40. That'll take any adhesive right off. Here I am sanding the tone hole edge. Make sure it's nice and clean. Don't sand too hard. You just want to clean it off, clean off any dirt. That's why I use a very fine sandpaper. Now I'm replacing the key back onto the saxophone. Make sure you don't over-tighten any of these rods or screws on the instrument. Especially on older instruments, it's easy to strip these things out, so be gentle with them. Then you put the leak light in and check to see that it's sealing properly. The side keys that are already pushed down by spring are usually pretty easy to fit and are easy to keep level. And again, you've got to look at the key from all different sides to make sure that there's no light coming out anywhere. Again, I refer you to other YouTube videos that show you how to do this. And that's it.